Hi guys, Halloween is coming and what would be Halloween without spiderwebs? So I made a completely free cobweb generator for you, which you can download on my website. And with that, you can just draw lines on any surface and it automatically creates cobwebs from it, which are also attached correctly to the objects. And this is super useful because with that you can do all kind of crazy stuff. And yeah, now I show you how you can use it. Basically, it's pretty simple. You just have to append it first. So search for the cobweb generator and append the collection. And then you can go to the modifiers tab. And here you can see all settings you can change. First of all, you have to select a collection where all the objects you want spiderwebs on must be inside. So in my case, I will choose the complete house with all its objects. But for that, I will reduce the contact points first to something like 0.1, because everything has a very large scale here. So what are the contact points? Basically, that are points that are projected on every object to which the spiderweb branches can connect to. So you have to look that you don't have too few contact points so that it has enough points to which the web can connect. But keep in mind, the more contact points you have, the more it could slow down your performance, especially if you have very large and many objects. Okay, then I choose the collection. And after that, I can go into the edit mode and select the pencil. And then you first also have to go to the tool and then set it to surface so that you can draw on the surfaces. And then I will draw a line like this. And here, as you can see, we already have our first spider web. Then we can play a bit with the settings. The coverage means how much of the middle part of the main line should be free, but it also reduces the number of branches. So for example, if I make this number higher, then we have less branches here and also more of the middle part is free. You can counteract with that a bit also with the density like this, but I set it to 0.05 now. And 0.5. With the width, you can control how long the branches are allowed to go. So if I set it to 50, for example, then the branches can go longer. And also you can control the hanging here. This, but I leave it to 0.2 for now. And also the radius. Okay, then we can also draw more lines. So for example, I go here to the window, and because every object is in the collection, I can connect everything. So for example, here, or I connect the window with the bed like this, and then I can also draw a line here. And what is also very cool, if the webs are close enough together, they also connect with each other. And then if I go to the render preview, yeah, as you can see, now here we have our spider webs. And it looks pretty cool, I guess. So yeah, I hope you liked it and you can download it for free on my website. And then I see you in the next video.